A common issue for a lot of windshield repair technicians is how to properly place the curing tab on the glass. In this video, we will show you how to get optimal results by storing your pit resin and properly placing the pit resin and curing tab on the glass. Before starting the repair process, turn your pit resin upside down in your top tray so that all the air bubbles rise to the top. By storing your pit resin bottle upside down, you should minimize air bubbles. This is what it should look like when stored properly. Here is an example of excessive air bubbles that can occur when the bottle is stored right side up. At this point in the video, we are going to skip to the removal of the bridge now that all of the air has been removed from the damage. Notice how the technician places one drop of pit resin just below the pit. By arching the curing tab back, you can maneuver the air bubbles away from the pit, reducing the chance of seeing an air bubble in the end. This is the same process from the technician's point of view. Notice the pit resin bottle remains upside down. A common mistake made by technicians is to place the pit resin directly over the pit. By doing so, you run the risk of leaving air bubbles in the pit. Notice this example. Another common mistake is pushing down on the curing tab after it has been placed on the glass. Doing so squeezes out the resin, preventing the finished repair from being flush to the glass. Do not open your bottle upright. Doing so will negate the fact that we turned it upside down before beginning the repair. This will create excessive air bubbles when it's time to place it on the glass.